You know where you are?
This is Nollywood Pictures TV.
M stands for mass, YA stands for acceleration. That is rate of motion of an object at a particular time. So by the time you know all these things, then you have to come down. You know, what there's nothing here is multiplication. Understand? There's no sign given here. Then you carry down the equation. You put down your F, then 12 times 6. Multiply, let me see.
Good afternoon.
Hi, good afternoon.
Can't you see I'm busy?
Oh, how to play Scrabble.
Hey. Wait. She will join you later, eh?
Tell Ogunede that I waited for 2 hours without seeing him with regards to her appointment.
I'll tell him.
I'll call back tomorrow.
Okay.
All right.
I really don't know what is keeping him till now, but I'll tell him if
I'll watch it. Call back.
Okay.
Okay.
My regards to your family.
All right.
Chief Guard sent me to deliver a message to you.
Sir, Remy? But I just left the palace. I hope all is well.
Yes, sir.
How can all be well when you're putting on this mood? What is happening?
Sir, on our way from the government house,
uh-huh,
His Royal Highness had a fatal accident.
Ah, sweet boy. Ah, sweet boy.
How? Where did it happen?
Sir, after Romi Market. But he has been taken to the Savannah Orthopedic Hospital.
Orthopedic.
If I can't talk to you right now, as you can see, I'm busy.
Going through. Auntie, I'm only allowed to come. Sweetheart, don't worry. They're all right. I'm sure they just stayed out. You visited so late. I hope there's no problem.
All is well. All is well. Can I have a word with you outside?
Chief, I hope nothing is wrong.
Everything is well.
So we have lost the point.
But what of the king? Ibunade?
He survived.
Oh, thank God.
But there's a problem.
What problem?
His spinal cord was affected.
What does that mean, doctor? Jim.
He cannot walk. He cannot climb stairs. In fact,
just wait. Are you implying that he cannot climb on the bed and make love to the second wife?
I'm afraid that one is impossible.
Azibobo. Azibobo. Ubunede.
Why Ubunede? What has he done to deserve this? How will Celestina react to this situation? Her chances of giving him an heir apparent has been defeated. There's a big problem. Who will assume the throne if anything happens to Ubunede? It is my right, or even the right of my son Henry, if anything happens to me. But God forbid.
It's okay, it's alright. See, no amount of crying will bring back the point. It's not possible. Now, I want to assure you of one thing. Whatever vacuum that has been created by her demise will be taken care of by God. Do you understand? So it's okay.
Are you not hearing me? Listen. No, punch it now.
Alright, it's okay. Kill it. Punch it is right.
Okay. Now, you, Celestina, if you break down like this, who will console the children? Who will be the solace in the whole situation? Now, you may not know it, but right now, you are the new queen of the house, the new mother in the whole place. So begin now to buckle up to your responsibilities. If they are to go to school or market or wherever, it is your duty to take care of all that. Do you understand? So don't break down as if there is no hope. Begin to live up to your new responsibility now. Oh? By the way, where is Neka?
One is upstairs. She has refused to eat. She refused to come down. She has refused to do anything.
Okay. I'll go and talk to her. I'll take care of that. Eventually, I'll go and discuss with the Uno to know the next line of action with regards to our customs and traditions. But I want to assure all of you of one thing. The demise of the queen will not be allowed to cause any devastating effect on anybody here.
I want to suggest that as a second in command to our king, the woman is one of your better form.
I should organize a delegation of cabinet members to go to the Queen's people and inform them of this calamity. Thereafter, you are going for her last burial rites.
I think you should wait for Bunede to recover and be discharged from the hospital before discussing Her Majesty's burial.
Ikemba, remember the doctor said Bunede need time to recover and should not be disturbed. Bringing the issue of Queen's burial before him when he is discharged might be too much for him to hear. So, we have to send some, cabinet delegates to inform the bereaved family and start making arrangements for her burial rites immediately. When the king is discharged, he will join us in mourning her.
The remains of your beloved wife, our queen.
Obligations, Your Highness. You owe me no gratitude, no.
Oh, I do a lot. My family told me how supportive you are. I am happy and lucky to have you as my brother.
Your Highness, you need rest. You need rest. And please excuse my presence to go and rest as well. From the ill-fated day till this moment, your subject has been restless. Please.
I think you should go and rest. You know, and please do not fail to see me tomorrow. There is something bothering my mind I wish to discuss with you.
Okay, okay. Long may the king.
May the Almighty God, the only true and all-knowing deity, continue to bless you, my brother.
I shall be here tomorrow, Your Highness. Thank
fine. I'm looking good.
You're looking better.
Thank you.
Meet Rita, my sister.
Welcome.
So where's he?
He went to the park.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Okay. So like I said, Papa, she's my friend and her name is Rita Weke. She's a mass communication student of Ibeh.Directed Federal Polytechnic.
Rita Weke?
Yes.
From where?
Weke, sir.
Weke?
Okay.
Ah. Okay. What of your parents?
They're very well, sir. Thank you.
Okay. You're welcome, my daughter.
Thank you, sir.
So, Henry, how was the interview?
Papa, I'm done with it and I must say it went well. I'm expecting my appointment letter soon.
All right. Yes. Oh, that's good. I like that.
So, Papa, if you will, excuse us, sir. We have to do something. But you mean all this happened to Obunende and I wasn't informed? Papa, that's not fair.
I didn't want to be distracted. And besides, the time was too short. You see, we had to bury the queen in the absence of Obunende because we didn't want anything to affect his condition of health.
Papa, wait a minute. Are you trying to say that the king did not see the queen's corpse?
It was after his discharge from the hospital that we now took him to the grave.
Your Highness, here lies the remains of your beloved wife.
I was just about going to see the king, you know, to apologize to him for not being around during the marriage ceremony of his second wife.
Even the idea behind marrying a second wife has now been defeated because the king is impotent. Yes. It's incredible that this. So, concerning your plan for Rita, I think it's good. It's a good step, really. After all, you're my only son. But I'm thinking that we're still in mourning mood. We're still mourning our situation. So what of shifting it to about 6 months ahead? It's reasonable.
Is this the end of Obunede? Obunede the peacemaker. Obunede the generous one. Oh ye gods, what have I done to deserve this punishment? My world has crumbled.
Daddy, what are you doing here all alone? Daddy, why are you shedding tears? Is it because of money?
My dear, you wouldn't understand.
Okay, Daddy, we have to leave here at once.
Let's not invite something that will come and destroy Ubula for kingdom just because of your condition of importance. Okay, what if his son adopted comes to dent the image of this royal family? Okay, what if madness runs in their blood? He could be an outcast or a robber.
Ambrose, I am running a temperature.
You see it? You see? You should rest. You deserve rest. You just got discharged from the hospital and you're thinking about issues like this. Don't allow them to bother you. Eh?
Remy? Remy?
Sir?
Come.
Remy, His Royal Highness deserves rest right now. So take him to the bedroom.
Please,
Your Highness, what is the problem? What is the problem, Your Highness? I just made you lunch and you refused to eat. And I'm giving you fruits and you still don't want to eat. Remember the doctor said that fruit is good for you. Oh, is it because your queen is no longer alive? I am here for you, Your Highness.
My dear, you won't understand.
Oh, that's what you always say. I will not understand. Ikwe, if your wife, the Queen, cannot understand, who else will? Yesterday you were here shedding tears, and when I asked you what the problem was, you told me I would not understand.
It's all right, my dear. You eat.
I should eat? How can I eat when you're not eating? I can't eat.
It's all right. It's all right, my dear.
I will accept that. Would you eat for me? Please.
must be. Can't you leave your home? I'm getting sick and tired of it.
Please just grant me audience for once. Please.
Look, Austin, I just logged off net because of you. Can't you understand? It can't work out between us. Harry has introduced me to his people. If not for a reason, I would have given you my wedding ID by now.
Rita, I understand. I understand. But you know I love him.
Save your pitching, let's keep.
Rita, please.
Your Highness, if you are comfortable with adoption, you should have taken the decision on your own without informing anybody.
Oh no. I'm only seeking your counsel on it. Now tell me, what do you think of it as an idea?
There's nothing wrong in it. But hence you have made it open. The mentality of your subjects has to be put into consideration in the interest of the child. If not, they won't see him as their king.
I see.
Your Highness, I have not given up hope on your recovery. You are the Ogunade one of Obelafo. Your legacies will ever remain green to our generations unborn. You abolished all the evil traditions of our people. You put smile on many faces. And life and marriages you saved are uncountable. I believe that our Creator, who gives life and takes, who has power to heal, must surely remember you.
Okay, what if his son adopted becomes to dent the image of this royal family? Okay, what if madness runs in their blood? He could be an outcast or a robber.
Your Highness, he was still here, all by himself. It's late now. It's not good for you to be here alone. Go to bed now.
It's not good for you to be here alone. My queen. I shall be long. I'll be with you.
No, I insist, Your Highness. My love. Daddy. Promise to meet us in our room and tell us the time story. No, sweetheart. No. Not today. It is late and Dad is tired and he has to go to bed. Okay?
No, Dad. You must fulfill your promise.
It is true, I give them my word. No, let me stay with them for a little while. I promise I shall be long.
Promise. Okay. Hey, take it easy on him, okay?
I am going to tell you a most fantastic story. I am a great storyteller. Once upon a time.
What do I do now?
honor in visiting me. You're welcome.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
What do I offer you?
Nothing. I'm fine.
Nothing?
Yeah.
I hope all is well.
It's about the king and I.
You and the king? Ah. Okay. I am listening.
Chief, you know, the Igwe has not slept on my bed since he was discharged from the hospital.
Azebubu.
He tries to avoid me once this night. I'm a woman. I have blood flowing through my veins. I need my husband's warmth.
Okay, okay. What else?
Most of the times he sits in isolated places, shedding tears. And when I try to ask him what the problem is, he keeps telling me that I will not understand. If the Igwe is missing his late wife, what is wrong with me? Am I not a woman?
Azebubu. Okay. The queen, I understand your situation. I know the pains you're going through. But let me say this. You have to pick courage and bear what I have to tell you now.
Okay, I will.
The Igwe's spinal cord that was affected in that fatal accident has made him impotent.
What?
Papa, I saw a royal guard outside. Any problem?
That's the point. The point is here to visit us.
Good day, Your Royal Highness. It's wonderful meeting you. I'm sorry for not being around during your traditional marriage. I was doing my national youth service then. Again, I'll say I'm sorry for the tragic incident that befell us.
Thank you.
I'll still come to the palace to see the king and my cousins.
Your Highness, Chief Ikem was here to see you when you were having your siesta.
What is it? My queen, please tell me what bothers you.
What have I done to you? Why have you decided to treat me like your maid?
My queen, please speak to me about what bothers you.
You never told me that your accident cost your potency.
You see, my dear, the doctor told me that I have a chance of full recovery. At the moment, I am going through tests and treatments. Besides, God Almighty, the all-knowing deity, shall show me mercy. After all, I have offended no one. Why should it be me? Why should it be mine?
It's okay, Your Highness.
What?
Speak no more. You'll be fine. It's okay.
she and her husband are trying to take you away. You only learned my husband left for me and my children.
Remy?
Yes, Your Highness.
I want you to summon the accused persons and bring them and the complainant before me.
Yes, Your Highness.
Where have you been?
Your Highness, I went to worry for an oil company interview after my national youth service.
And how was the interview?
It went very well, Your Highness. I'm actually expecting my appointment letters.
Good, good. If you suspect any delay, you let me know and then I will take necessary actions for immediate result.
Thank you very much, Your Highness. Thank you. Your Highness, I'm very sorry for the unfortunate.
Oh. Those have gone with yesterday. Thank you for your concern. Alhaji Usman, grant him immediate access.
Well, Your Highness, let me go continue my chat with my cousins.
Happy stay.
This mood you're putting on does not actually befit your beautiful face. If I may ask, what's the matter? Your Highness, your glass is empty and you're not drinking.
You don't feel that.
Now, what is making my queen sad? Is it the king, the gods, the maids, or is it...
I told you, you will not understand, okay? Forget it, Henry.
My queen, I am the oldest grandson of Odemezuwe's dynasty. And if you permit me to say we fall within the same age bracket, we are young. And as such can understand ourselves better.
My queen, Your Highness sends for you. The Commissioner of Police would like to greet you.
Lovely times we spent together.
They're in the past, Austin. You never saw your wife in me. Someone else has and he has proposed. What do you expect me to do?
Come on, Rita. I wanted our relationship to work out. I wanted our relationship to take a good shape. Then stabilize our means of survival. Then propose to you at the right time. That's all.
That time is what I don't have now. As you can see, I'm on my way out.
You don't have that time.
I don't. I want to leave.
For me. Is it because he's from a royal family?
Well, whatever you want to say, you say.
like I said before, I am on my way out.
Abominable. We're being our family stupid to an outsider owner who may not have your interests at heart. Or giving this wise counsel to your wife, who is part of our family.